One time, I was with the Jama'ah of the Murids, and we were in the Majlis of Mawlana Sheikh Nazim and Mawlana Sheikh Hisham in Fenton, Michigan. In Fenton, Michigan, in America, where Mawlana Sheikh Hisham lives. Mawlana had invited Mawlana Sheikh Nazim, and he had come to America, and we made such a big celebration, and everyone was swimming in love. Mawlana Sheikh Nazim was there, Mawlana Sheikh Hisham was there, his brother Mawlana Sheikh Adnan was there, and there were others also, maybe Sheikh Raja Ashman, I think he was there, and others from Malaysia, from England, and Turkey, and Arab countries, and Canada, of course, all coming, mashallah. And there was lots of activities. And that day it was evening, and we had prayed Isha, and Mawlana made Khatm. And we were reciting Khatm Khaja Khan, but everyone was very tired. It was late. People want to go and rest. We wanted to sleep. But Mawlana was, Mawlana Sheikh Nazim was making the zikr longer even, stretching it, and I was trying to stay awake. I was struggling, and Mawlana was slowing, making it slower. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Like that. La ilaha. And I was trying to stay away, but it's like Mawlana was like that. I looked like that at Mawlana. And Mawlana, his eyes were closed and he was smiling. La ilaha illallah, like that. Subhanallah. Mawlana, I understood that Mawlana did not mind if we fall asleep. He's not going to say, don't do this. No. He knows. He knows our weakness, he knows our limitations, he knows our fatigue, he knows our... So, go ahead and sleep. Don't worry, Yani. So, their hearts are like surgeons operating on us, and the patient, we are the patient. The patient does not need to be wide awake, and checking and asking, what is your dalil to the doctor? Imagine. That would be a patient who stays awake and who asks the doctor, what is your dalil before you do the operation? That must be the most stupid patient in the whole world. Most stupid. See, Yahoo, don't be square head. Mawlana says, square head. Think. Salim. You are in their hands. You don't mind if you are in the hands of the doctor, he puts you under, you go. You don't know if you are alive or dead. And here is the not even a Muslim doctor with a knife over your heart. And okay, Musallam, okay. You don't ask any question. But when it comes to your sheikh who is 80, 90 years old, your sheikh who has kissed the Hajar al-Asad and Hajar al-Aswad at the Kaaba, who has done Hajj 40 times or more, on their feet sometimes, and who has received amana, who is yani muhaqqaq, you ask him for dalil. Mashallah. This is hikmah? This is not even adab. So fas'alu ahla dhikri in kuntum la ta'lamun. Ask the people of zikr if you do not know. There are teachers who can teach you, plenty of teachers. Allah is saying, ask Ahl al-Kitab, they will tell you, yes, yes, it's true, they will confirm. If you need confirmation from outside, from Ahl al-Kitab to confirm, yeah, your Quran is haq, because our Injil says the same, our Torah says the same. Yani, believe in one true God. So, but always asking for dalil. Ya Rabbi, we are weak and we are poor. One time, Imam Bukhari, he was in one mosque. I will tell you this after the translation.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Beliau berkisah kepada kita bahwa suatu ketika beliau di Fenton, Michigan bersama dengan Maulana Syekh Nadim, Maulana Syekh Hisham, Maulana Syekh Adnan dan Raja Asman dan banyak orang pada saat itu. Mereka begitu asyik bersama satu sama lain. Namun pada hari itu mereka sudah mulai letih, satu sama lain sudah merasa keletihan, kecapean karena kegiatan yang pada saat itu. Namun Maulana Syekh Nadim masih terus melakukan khatam, bahkan dia lakukan zikir itu dengan begitu lambat dan dia tutup matanya lalu dia tersenyum dan begitu menikmati zikir itu, sedangkan para jemaah pada saat itu sudah mulai sangat-sangat letih untuk mengikuti zikir. Namun walaupun seperti itu, Syekh Nadim tidak memaksakan kepada mereka. Siapapun yang mau ikut-ikut, yang mau tidur silakan tidur. Tidak ada paksaan untuk itu semua. Lalu beliau berkisah kepada kita bahwa kita semua ini adalah ibaratnya seperti pasien yang menghadapi dokter. Ketika kita menghadapi dokter, kita tutup mata kita boleh, kita terjaga boleh, kita tidak dipaksakan untuk membuka mata kita terus-menerus. Namun kita boleh tertidur dan berserah diri kepada dokter tersebut. Bahkan tidak jarang dokter yang kita hadapi itu bukan seorang Muslim. Namun kita nggak pernah bertanya kepada dokter itu kenapa begini, kenapa begitu. Kita nggak pernah bertanya. Kita hanya bertanya terus-menerus kepada syekh kita. Kita bertanya kenapa begini, kenapa begitu, mana dalilnya dan lain sebagainya. Itu tidak patut kita lakukan dan itu bukan bagian daripada adab. Itu adalah perbuatan dungu yang seperti itu. Kita dengan non-muslim bisa tidak bertanya, mengapa dengan syekh kita yang sudah begitu sepuh kita masih bertanya untuk hal-hal yang seperti itu. Lalu beliau katakan, fas'alu ahlal zikir, maka bertanyalah kepada mereka ahlul zikir yang lebih mengetahui ketimbang daripada kita. Wahai Tuhan kami, begitu lemahnya diri kami ini dan betapa miskinnya diri kami ini.
So there was a story of Imam Bukhari. His student was with him, and his student is telling the story that he saw his sheikh do this like that. He was in one of the mosques, in Tashkent or Samarkand or Bukhara. And you know, this is just to show how we do some things sometimes and we don't think, we don't realize we are making a mistake. So Imam Bukhari, he saw someone you know, cleaning his shirt or something like this and doing like this, you know, this shirt, and in the mosque. And so there were it was maybe a halaqa or something, and Imam Bukhari saw this, and his student noticed that his face was you know, changed, and then he checked, no one said did anything, and he waited until it was finished and everyone left. Then he went and he picked it up like that and he put it in his pocket, you know, to clean the mosque. Because we don't think that, you know, if you see something on your clothes, you immediately you clean it, you remove it. So if you are in your house, you do that. If you are in the street, you do that. If you are in the bus, okay, no problem. But when we are in the mosque, you see, everything is different. This we are supposed, yani, even with our beard, we'll clean the floor of the mosque for the believers to come and be able to pray, and it will be salat sahiha, and you will have ajr. You will have ajr, the cleaner of the mosque. So I always remember that story. I read it maybe 30, 35 years ago. And even now, I think of Imam Bukhari, and I'm in the mosque, I see someone, just, you know, like, without thinking, where are you cleaning off the dirt from your clothes to where? You throw it in a dump? We don't realize. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, subhanallah wa astaghfirullah. Isn't it?
Yeah. Ada kisah daripada Imam Ghazali yang menceritakan tentang Imam Bukhari di masjid ketika itu, entah di Tashkent atau di Bukhara. Beliau suatu ketika dia dalam masjid itu mencoba membersihkan bajunya. Kita kadang-kadang membersihkan baju kita, lalu debu-debu itu berjatuhan ke atas karpetnya, lantai daripada masjid itu. Maka setelah daripada majelis itu selesai, dia ambil satu persatu lagi debu-debu yang jatuh itu, lalu dia kantongin seperti itu. Kadang-kadang kita melakukan hal seperti itu. Kadang-kadang kita melakukan kesalahan, namun kita tidak menyadarinya. Dan begitu juga ketika kita di masjid, ketika kadang-kadang kita mengeluarkan kotoran, tapi sebenarnya kita tidak sadar bahwa itu kita tidak boleh mengotori masjid.
ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار.
آمين.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد النبي الرحمة. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد النبي التوبة.
آمين.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد النبي الشفاعة. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد صاحب المقام المحمود. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد صاحب قاب قوسين أو أدنى.
آمين.
اللهم قربنا إليك بسيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وبجاه الأنبياء والمرسلين والملائكة والمقربين ومشايخنا الكرام في الطريقة النقشبندية العلية.
آمين.
واجعل هذه السنة سنة مباركة في وسائر السنين الباقية من أعمارنا يا أكرم الأكرمين لنا ولأحبابنا ولآبائنا وأمهاتنا ولعوامنا وأعمامنا وعماتنا ولأخوالنا وخالاتنا ولإخواننا وأخواتنا ولأزواجنا ولأولادنا ولأصحابنا ولأحبابنا ولمشايخنا ولسائر المسلمين يا أكرم الأكرمين ويا أرحم الراحمين، خاصة إلى روح إمام الطريقة وآثر خليق حجاب الدين أجمن مولانا سلطان الأولياء مولانا الشيخ عبد الفائز الداغستاني مولانا سلطان الأولياء مولانا الشيخ محمد ناظم الحقاني مولانا سلطان الأولياء مولانا الشيخ هشام قباني وعبد الخالق الجدواني وسائر ساداتنا والصديقين الفاتح.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد